一部食べにっていう実装とか、普通に普通の意味がすみません。これはそこはデスネーションです。This is the other who was that to be a woman. The party in the document of the middle of South America is really a woman. We've taken away our job. We've taken no one with us. We don't pay taxes, but that was from using government resources. That happens to all of us.只是看这个的话，那你没有太大的难度啊。嗯，这一点就是难度啊。嗯。哦，哇操！这就是一个哇操！他们都看见 NS 里面有，有一个回复，居然回复 NS。性质就是一个平面图，我觉得这平面图啊，怎么说就是一种非常基础的东西，基础的，因为它是符合知识性的平面图，所以它自然的可能这样的，他就想平面图，他不想平面图，我就是死了对吧？
我们去
切
花
篮
哦。
所以 you just have to chapter two.
Chapter two. 这花英语怎么讲？啊？
哦，是的。
这花英语怎么讲？教我一下吧。Flower. 叫 flower。走吧。
第一个，你要对作者本身的。
Second.
因为 that next to of especially 年代。这个全是 about material published。这个材料是不是最新的材料 ？Is it material published？ 这是什么意思？要 prepare for the open text of the text of the Javier Solitaire. 其他两个也都没有讲。Prepare for the open text book, open text, open book text.
Traditional American values and beliefs. We hold this truth to be self-evident that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights, as a bonus of earnings of love, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And the pursuit of happiness. I think it's very, very good. We hold this truth to be self-evident that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by the Creator with certain inalienable rights, that the boundaries are love, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
tools are critical reading of American culture. In this micro lecture, we will review the content of chapter 2. For this,
Traditional
American values and beliefs in the textbook, American Ways, an introduction to American culture.
American Ways, the project of American culture.
Chapter 2, Chapter
2.
Chapter 2 is perhaps the most important chapter in the whole book. The six traditional American values described in this chapter form the basic framework of the American culture. There are five sections in this chapter. In the first section, the authors draw our attention to cultural pluralism, which is the context of traditional American values. In the next three sections, the authors...
Cultural pluralism.
Examine the historical origins and meanings of six traditional American values. In the last section, the focus is the American dream and a preview of the rest of the chapters. At the end of this micro lecture, two questions will be asked, which are to be prepared before class. Now, let's begin with the context of traditional American values. It is the racial, ethnic, religious, and cultural diversity of the United States. Since the beginning of the American history, most Americans have recognized cultural pluralism, or diversity, as a fact of life. Then, how could a nation of enormous diversity produce a recognizable national identity? The answer of John Zogby, an American poster, is, the Americans all share a common set of values that make them American. What are the common set of values? There are six traditional American values according to the authors. They are in three pairs: individual freedom and self-reliance, equality of opportunity and competition, material wealth and hard work. In each pair, the first represents a traditional reason or benefit of immigrants coming to America. It's also a right the Americans believe they have. The second indicates a responsibility or the price to be paid. The first pair of values includes individual freedom, and the first represents, according to the authors, reliance. Equalities includes individual freedom and self-reliance. The early settlers came to the North American continent and established colonies for individual freedom, the most basic of all American values. By limiting the power of the government and the churches and eliminating aristocracy, the early settlers created a climate of freedom where the emphasis was on the individual. How do we Americans understand individual freedom? By freedom, Americans mean the desire and the right of all individuals to control their own destiny without outside interference, like government, the ruling noble class, the church, or any other organized authority.
No ruling noble class, no church, no organized authority. No, no authority. No authority. What does individual freedom mean? He explained very well. No, the government is not as strong. The government is not as strong. No, the noble class. Church.
The cost for individual freedom is self-reliance. To be self-reliant, individuals must rely on themselves and take responsibility for themselves. They must achieve financial and emotional independence from their parents by age 18 or 21. They should take care of themselves, solve their own problems, and stand on their own two feet. Most Americans believe that they must be self-reliant to keep their freedom. Relying on the support of families, government, or any organization may result in losing some of their freedom. Therefore, they usually expect receiving financial support from charity, family, or the government to be a short-term arrangement. In reality, equality of opportunity and self-reliance may not necessarily describe the reality of American life. Some people, those born into rich families, have a better chance for success than others. Race and gender may also be factors affecting success. The second pair of traditional American values are equality of opportunity and competition. Generations of immigrants have felt that they have a better chance for personal success in the United States because they are free from excessive political, religious, and social controls. Early immigrants, in particular, left the aristocratic working societies, where their place of life was determined largely by the social class into which they were born. Many of them fulfilled their hopes and dreams of rising to a higher social position in the new country. To the Americans, equality of opportunity doesn't mean everyone is or should be equal. It means each individual should have an equal chance for success, an equal chance to enter the race for success. Anyway, this American concept of fair play is an important aspect of a belief in equality of opportunity. The price for equality of opportunity is communication. If every person has an equal chance to succeed, then it's every person's duty to run the race in order to succeed. Competition causes Americans to be energetic, so competitive sports are popular in the United States. Meanwhile, competition brings Americans pressure in life, emotional strain in particular, which begin in childhood and continue until retirement from work. Any group of people who do not compete successfully do not fit into the mainstream of American life. Now we come to the last pair of values, material wealth and hard work. Many immigrants have come to the United States to have a better life, namely raising their standards of living. Because of the abundant natural resources of the North American continent, many immigrants
为什么就是没有这种不太用心？我就是特别残酷，所以我觉得很不错。
黄帝内经没退。In addition, there are also many outstanding medical books. 黄帝内经written in Qing and Han dynasties is the earliest extant book of traditional Chinese medicine. Compendium of Materia Medica, written by Li Shizhen, a medical scholar in Ming dynasty, which recorded about 2,000 herbs and over 10,000 prescriptions. So the book is regarded as a masterpiece of Oriental medicine. Except for these two books, Treatise on Febrile and Miscellaneous Disease by Zhang Zhuji, Tianjin Yao Fang by Sun Simiao and the like, are also classic medical writings. Since the 20th century, the Western medicine has been developing very fast. Some have asked whether traditional Chinese medicine is still useful in the modern society. Here is the answer. Traditional Chinese medicine is not only surviving, but also thriving. In 2015, chemist Hu Youyou from the China Academy of Traditional Chinese Medicine won the Nobel Prize for deriving an anti-malaria drug from sweet wormwood, which is a traditional Chinese medicine. Other researchers have proved traditional medicine's effectiveness at tackling everything from eczema to infection.
Professional is the TCN, its annual global compendium that extracts doctors around the world.
A COVID-19 shut the world, TCN contains three solutions to the treatment. According to the National Administration of TCN, TCN has been used to treat over 85% of the coronavirus cases in China. Besides, TCN has been used to help many other countries to fight against COVID-19, including Italy, France, Brazil, etc. From the point of view of Chinese medicine, COVID-19 is an epidemic. It is the result of a transition between regional history, where our immune system becomes weaker than usual and susceptible to the epidemic in asthma. According to Huang Yinhui, the prevention of epidemic is to avoid the miasma, which means refraining from visiting crowded places to avoid infecting others or getting infected. The book also mentions the importance of boosting vitamin C, which means improving immunity. TCM has proved effective in relieving COVID-19 symptoms, such as fever, cough, and fatigue. It has also helped to shorten the duration of disease. TCM is a great treasure of China, which shows the industry as well as the intelligence of China's people. Nowadays, practitioners are trying to improve TCM and make it more demand. Here are our division of work and our references. If you are interested in it, you can communicate with us or go to this website to search for more information. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. According to the National Association Improving Immunity, TCM has proved effective in relieving COVID-19 symptoms, such as fever, cough, and fatigue. It has also helped to shorten the duration of hospitalization, prevent non-serious cases from developing into serious ones, improve the recovery rate, and reduce the death rate. Undoubtedly, TCM is a great treasure of China, which shows the industry as well as the intelligence of China's people. Nowadays, practitioners are trying to improve TCM and make it more suitable for the modern world. I hope we can be confident of our traditional medicine and expect it to make larger contributions to the mankind. Here are our division of work and our references. If you are interested in traditional Chinese medicine, you can communicate with us or go to this website to search for more information. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching.
His modern society.
He has also helped to shut.
like this.
The brains have achieved materialism, going from rags to riches. Thus, material wealth became a value to the Americans. Material wealth has traditionally been a widely accepted measure of social status in the United States. It is a substitute for European system of hereditary aristocracy in judging social status. Acquiring and maintaining a large number of material possessions is important to most Americans, but they do not like to be called materialistic, because this means the person values material possessions above all else. The price paid for material wealth is hard work, which is both necessary and rewarding. Many Americans now see material possessions as the natural reward for their hard work. They believe that people should have jobs and not live off welfare payments from the government. Recently, hard work has been challenged. When the economy weakens, there has been a decline in high-paying jobs for factory workers and an increasing number of the working poor. They work hard, but they have low-paying jobs. It is very difficult for the average worker to go from rags to riches now. Now we have some idea of the six traditional values. We will move on to the next topic, the American dream. What is the American dream? Traditionally, it meant that parents can enable their children to have a better life when they grow up. Every generation could be a little more prosperous and successful than their parents. It is the belief that if people take the responsibility for their lives and work hard, they will have the individual freedom to pursue their personal goals and a good opportunity to compete for success. In recent years, as the economy has declined, the distance between the very rich 1% and the rest of the population has dramatically increased. However, the overwhelming majority of Americans still believe in the ideal of the American dream. If they work hard, they and their children can have a better life. Although American ideals are only partly carried out in real life, most Americans still believe in them and are strongly affected by them in their everyday life. We need to remember several things about the six values discussed in this chapter. First, the six values are cultural values. They are the cultural engine of the United States. Second, putting the six values together into a system creates something new. The rights and responsibility relationship among the creates the fabric of the American society. Third, the six cultural values do not tell the whole story of the American character, but they form the basic structure of the American culture.
this girl, my own mother does, and especially with power to a normal girl. And Mary was the last in my senses came. I was very for the future of my husband's name. As a marriage number two, I knew what to do. My grasp of the infinite so problem number one, now problem number two. He stole the girl with gender for the few. What I ship to office with, no one ever is to say that she had to earn her kid. So she became the man. She was sleeping, she was sleeping, she was talking to the man. She was hopefully naive, so she had to pay it twice. I took her to the end, I was excited out of one. I fell from her out, unbelievable, and cried. Mother, your hands to me.
对吧？
我也喜欢另外。